Hi everybody, welcome again to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Welcome to my channel. Today I speak about the power head, how is it made up, and how it actually works. Stay tuned. Okay, so you have what you call the impeller. Now they come in various size, depending on the GPH in which the power head is expected to actually, you know, push out, right? Now this is a 80 GPH power head. A very small power head. Probably this could go into probably a 20 gallon or a 30 gallon, right, to form a part of its filtration system. Okay, so you have what you call the impeller, right? And the impeller is what actually takes the water from the outside and flush it up. I'll be showing that very shortly, right? And then you have what you call the shaft. Now depending on how small the power head is, the shaft can be a metal little pipe, fine pipe like, or it can actually be built into the power head itself. Because it is so small, this one is built in the power head, and anytime this one actually rocks out, that's it's just done, can't be used again. All right, so let's fit up this power head and see how it works. Okay, so first thing, I put the impeller in. Impeller is in, then I put the cover on. Now this section of the power head right here I'm pointing at, it acts like a vacuum, which actually sucks in the water, and as it sucks in the water is actually channeled through a small hole there, which will come up to the top of the right here, and it will end up go wherever you want it to go. So let's see how that one works. Okay, so now the base of the power head is on. Now what will happen is that the water will be sucked in using the impeller from here, right, and it actually the channel should little opening on the top of the power head. As I said before, this is about 60-80 GPH. That means it doesn't go more than probably about 1 foot. If positioned properly, it doesn't go more than 1 foot, right? 1 or 2 foot, right? So the tank have to be shallow to use this, all right? But it's very, very useful in an aquarium. Let's say that you have some small fish and they are not as big to go through these creases, but they are heavy poopers, right? So as the impeller actually spins, it actually acts as a suction, sucks in the water, and the water comes through the top. I'm gonna try and see if I can get it up a little bit to show you the water actually come up to the top of the power head. Now at the base of the power head are some of the slots where the water is expected to actually go through. Now if you have this thing on and the impeller is actually spinning and it's not into the water, what will happen is that the magnet that is on the impeller will actually burn out and eventually it will stop work. Now this is like an electronic magnet, right? I'll speak more about that in a bit. So I'll like the bottom side of the power head, this will actually go in front of the spinning section, we call the impeller, right, when it's covered.
If by some chance you leave the power head out of water and it's spinning, and this is the magnet stripping which I'm speaking about, what happens is that inside of the power head is an electrical circuitry, right? This electrical circuitry becomes magnetized as you plug it in. Now if the magnet is not being cooled as it spin, you know, it's in the water, so it's at like a few centimeters away from the actual casing itself, what will happen is that it will burn. And if it is a large power head, what will happen after a while, it will just seize up, like weld together, right? So power head, you have to know the tricks and the trade as to how to use it. The water will be channeled upwards, as I said before, it's taken from the base, and the shaft and the impeller are the, you know, those parts that you can be that can be replaced, right? However, it's a little bit technical. If you actually have a power head that is the parts are not really readily available, you will have a problem with that. But this is it from Fish Keeping Jamaica. This is it from me. Do have a wonderful day. I hope that this video was of interest to you. There are larger versions to this, which pumps like 2,000, 3,000 or more. And the motors, shall I say, the impeller are very large. Bye-bye for now. Cool.